Ladies and gentlemen, you're most welcome to our fourth graduation ceremony to Horizon International School, Uganda. My name is Dennis Owora, and I'm the head teacher of the school. Today, we celebrate achievement. We celebrate a journey which started when they were crying. We celebrate a journey which started with their sixes into primary school. Some were still crying. And we celebrate those who are completing the secondary education and they are heading into university. On this occasion, our three classes, we are celebrating the exception class, incidentally international education, we call top class exception. They are the young ones you see over here. So, exception class, how are you? Are you okay? Good. We are celebrating you. Next year, you're going to join primary school. The routine of exception class helps the learner to fit into the rigorous process of primary. And our learners are ready. They have been taken through all the processes and all the activities. They have enough skills that will help them to manage primary school. For those celebrating the completion of primary school, our primary school ends at year 6. We don't go up to P7. So For them, they are going to join year 7 next year, which is the first class of secondary school. We are celebrating them also, and we congratulate them. They have enough skills also to join the secondary category and succeed in all the aspects of the secondary education. For those joining secondary, the journey now begins into more rigorous education. Secondary education requires a lot of personal management. It requires a lot of personal thinking and also following instructions. Unlike primary, where the class teacher is there all the time, in secondary school to be different. Your parent comes to visit you all the time in the primary, in secondary they may not, and we have to manage. So the journey coming forward needs preparation, needs resilience. For my friends joining university, the year 13s are going to university. Year 13 is the last class of secondary education in international education. For them, they have been skilled in different areas. So you see future accountants, future doctors, future psychologists, forensic people, they are all here. And I congratulate them. Today, the world requires someone who is innovative and skilled. At Horizon, these students you see here, going to university, they are well skilled to manage themselves. And we wish them the best.
Ladies and gentlemen, and all our graduates who are here today, we want to congratulate you for the efforts that you have made in order to be here today with us. My name is Grace Arapu, and I'm a teacher in reception class. So I want to talk about what we have accomplished this year as reception class. Reception class, they have made tremendous progress in all various areas of development. They have made a transformation from preliminary activities that involve much of adult input into self-motivated and independent skills. Learning has become more formal. They have been more understanding in their contribution to kindergarten. We are really going to miss them. Their growth and development has really shown us that they are ready to face the future with confidence and courage. We also want to thank our teachers and our parents. They have been cooperative, they contributed a lot, and they have been part of their children's learning. And we all believe that learning begins at home, and talking is an investment for life. So working together with our parents has really motivated, benefited, and boosted our learners' confidence. As usual, as every year, it is time to say goodbye to them, but we really want to assure you that we have given them the necessary skills that will enable them to cope with changes in a positive way, and they will shine wherever they will be. Now it's time to say goodbye and wish them all the best in their first journey of life.
Vihana Kotecha, congratulations. Let's clap for Vihana Kotecha, congratulations. Let's clap for Vihana. We have Aksam Kinene. This is a victory. It has not been easy, 3 years in kindergarten. Next, we have Amara Electra Piba. She's so happy. Let's clap for Amara. Next is Pras Patel. This is your victory. Atharvi Patel. Atharvi Patel. Atharvi, congratulations. This is your Rajan Tamka. All right, let's clap for all our graduates from kindergarten reception class. Photo moment, someone help them.
On behalf of the institution, we convey our greetings and also have the honor to be part of this wonderful, auspicious occasion. I want to tell you, I am not new to international education. Among my children, I have both products of international schools and local curriculums. I want to tell the parents here today, this is a great investment, and I want to thank the promoters of this wonderful institution which has come to Jinja. This is a great stride. This is an international school at Cambridge level. You have your certificate from such an institution, the sky is the limit. I want to encourage the parents who are here and those who have not brought their children to this institution to know that we have a great asset in Jinja, Busoga, and Uganda in general. Education is the process of acquisition of knowledge, skills, morals, and habits. When you bring your child to school, you bring your child to get exposed to society. This is where your child is shaped to venture into society. This is where your child will acquire discipline, skills, behaviors, and how to manage society. I want to thank the management of this school for the great job that you have done. It's a great pleasure indeed for us to have such an institution amidst our environment. I want to congratulate all the students who have made to this successful day. It's a great pleasure, it's a great honor. We wish you all the best. Please be useful citizens, go out, explore your skills, your knowledge to translate into meaningful things to society. Ladies and gentlemen, in your various capacities, are most welcome to Horizon College Jinja to witness our graduation from the various levels to the next levels. My name is Wabuche Johnson, the year 6 class teacher. I will extend my thanks to the parents that have trusted us with their children and believed in us that we shall do the best. Indeed, we are doing the best with the children. To the teachers that I work with, I would like to thank you for partnering with me and the rest of the school to make sure we turn these boys and girls into successful viers of the secondary education. The administration, thank you so much for your input. It means a lot to create such an institution and provide education as you are doing. To my dear students, they have been my brothers and sisters. I've not only been their teacher, as much as they knew my position in the class. They always respected me. They've done their best. They have learned, and I am here to affirm and to confirm that they are ready for secondary education. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, the campus is so large. We are still open for all those that you'd wish to entrust us with, and we shall offer them the best. Thank you very much for coming.
Congratulations, year six. Congratulations, Emerson. Let's clap for Emerson. He's now a graduate to year seven, secondary school. Well done.
Hemal.
Hemal, congratulations. Let's clap for Hemal. Year seven is waiting for you.
Birungi, hey Dave.
Dave, congratulations. Welcome to year seven, secondary school. You will enjoy it, I promise.
Ella, Sophie.
Ella, congratulations. Welcome to secondary school. Let's clap for Ella. Welcome to secondary school. Let's clap for Sarah. And celebration. Congratulations.
Krisha Hitesh Kumar.
Krisha, congratulations. Welcome to secondary. Keep your smile through year 7 till year 13.
Alicia Mitul Kumar.
Congratulations, Alicia. I'm sure you'll enjoy year 7.
Alicia Mirembe.
Congratulations, Alicia. Alicia, this is your day of victory. Enjoy secondary school.
Take your body, baby, swap from me. Tô ficando crazy, faz assim. Tô vendo pra aprender direitinho. E pra cima.
E aí? Eu te pongo louca, louca dessa. Tá ficando crazy, faz assim. Mira que aprendeste direitinho. Tipo assim.
You're most welcome to the fourth graduation ceremony in Horizon College Jinja. Standing before you is Mr. Kasuja Rashid, class teacher year 13, the outgoing class, who are the university students of the coming year. It's been a long journey. Some of them have been here since the school started. The class I'm presenting today has got the first two students when the school had three only students for almost a week. They have been here since that day to date. In a special way, I'll recognize Hiral Havi and Diani Patel. I'd request the class to be with me here, please, because it will be better. It's a class of 8 students, and I have only one male student. But I've been able to manage the class. Hiral Havi and Diani Patel, please step forward for recognition. Those are the students I've been talking about. They have been here since the school began. Whatever you've gone through, they are there to give a testimony. They're the most charitable students I have in my class. The most charitable. all the charity organizations we have done in this school, they have been spearheaded by these students. The class has been represented all the time with a person with the best leadership skills, and that is Nasreen Nachito. Please step forward. Smaya Beta, we nickname Hajito. She's the most disciplined of all. She has always been carrying our certificates. Sometimes we look for something bad to talk about her, we fail to get it. I have the most courageous student, Ikran Osman. We don't push her. She pushes herself and pushes others to do what they are supposed to do. Karen Roxanne Ali, the most sociable student. She calls for interaction everywhere. And then I have the most incredible IT personnel. Most of the digital piece of work in this school has been done by the only gentleman I have in this class, Karimin Narawala. I have nothing much to say about this class. Otherwise, I mean, they are going to leave me in a lot of, can't mention it, but this has been one of my best classes. This is my third graduation as a class teacher to year 13, but I'm going to really miss this class because we have been working as a team. Everybody would mind about the other. Absence of one person would make the whole class feel it. We couldn't let one another off. I'm going to miss them, but only what I can say is that please light Horizon College wherever you go. Horizon College is known as an institution beyond the horizons. Please raise our flag and always be a good example. Gwitachi has been called to make a speech here. So many others were invited, but it was on a short notice. But we always want to call you back because you always be lighting us. That's the class. Allow me to present the awards to them.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's an honor to see today these wonderful students who have accomplished their secondary school and making it to this level. The time is against us. Allow me to invite our chief guest who is representing here, Right Honorable Kadaga, on her behalf. Please, Madam Loy Katali, Women MP of Jinja Municipality, you're most welcome.
Presenting to you the graduates, Smaya Beta.
Congratulations, Sumaya, for the achievement. Let's clap for Sumaya. Woo, you deserve the victory. Congratulations.
Congratulations and jubilation. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be.
Congratulations, Sumaya. Thank you for the perseverance. You did it.
Next is Diani Ananti Patel.
Woo! Congratulations, Diani. Thank you so much for your being a very good student.
Congratulations.
Next is Nasreen Nachito.
Congratulations, Nasreen. You deserve the victory. A very dedicated student. Let's give her a hand clap.
When I tell everyone that you're in love with me.
Next is Garima Mehta.
Congratulations, Garima.
I want the world.
You deserve the victory. A student who is always reading, very dedicated. Congratulations.
Next is Karimin Kushuru Nawala.
Congratulations, KY. Let's clap for KY. You deserve the victory.
Congratulations.
You did it.
And celebration. When I tell everyone.
Presenting to you, Ikran Osman Ahmed.
Congratulations, Ikran.
And jubilation.
Let's give her a hand clap.
I want the world
to know I'm happy.
Thank you for the patience, for the resilience, for never giving up.
Karen Loxini Ali.
Congratulations, Karen. You did it.
Congratulations.
You are ready for the next step. Enjoy university.
When I tell everyone that you're in love with me.
Congratulations, Hiral. One of the most dedicated students. She does all her research. Hope you carry it forward to university. Up until yesterday, I could not possibly think of a good way to start this speech, because Miss Edith, our literature teacher, often said to us, and I quote, always try to start with an attention grabber. And I'm sitting there scratching my head thinking, and then I realize, what is a better attention grabber than the eight of us successfully graduating from one of the major aspects of our lives? Because despite all the odds, and don't get me wrong, the world is full of disasters. We've got war, disease, global warming, face at me. And despite all the hardships each of us has faced personally, we have managed to reach here. I would like to take this moment and thank our teachers for all the time and dedication they have devoted onto us and stuck by us even when it got tough. There are especially some teachers who are staying far away from their own families, making a huge sacrifice just to ensure our future success in education, and in this way have ensured to take care of us like we were their own children. They have groomed us into being better people, and everything that they have taught us over these years, apart from studies, is going to help us survive in the outside world. It was only 4 years ago that we arrived here, and it is now time to leave. How did it all go so fast? But this moment is more than just about this one ceremony. Everything that has happened over these years holds a special place in my heart, and I'm sure it holds a special place in your hearts too. I personally was the very first student who joined this school, and I have seen the school grow into what it has become today, and I, for one, I can proudly say that it has emerged into a fine institution. Now, as we end our careers as high school students, it is our time to take on to the world, to find, to pursue, and to achieve our greater passions. To quote William Shakespeare, some are born with greatness, some have achieved greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them. In life, we cannot always count on being born great or have greatness thrust upon us, but achieving greatness is absolutely in our own control. Most of our great political and social leaders started as an average person, a person like you and me. We find that even the average have created greatness for themselves, and therefore we should not ever hold back or be led to believe that you are simply not good enough. If there is anything we learn from today, it is that greatness should not be defined as money and recognition, but rather being able to leave each person we cross paths with a little happiness and joy. So as we climb down the Horizon International steps for the very last time, let us all remember ourselves as people with the as people with the best or worst grades, or as the most or least popular, but as people who have acquired equally great achievements as individuals and as a team. Class of 2019, I can't think of a better way to have spent these remarkable high school years and face every difficulty than to have gone through it with you. It has been a great journey, and I wish you all the very, very best.
take this opportunity to welcome you all to this OGS occasion as we honor and celebrate our learners' academic journey. On 24th January 2015, Horizon International School Uganda was officially opened as a model institution for affordable international education that is dedicated to providing learner-centered education. Cultural awareness and diversity and openness to new ways of thinking, including practical applications of solutions to life. This would not have been possible without the utmost support of the government of Republic of Uganda. Through the Ministry of Education and Sports and other organs of the government that created a welcoming and academically favorable environment that has enabled us to maximize our potential in educating the leaders of tomorrow. You have supported us for the start and continue to serve us in the best way possible. You are all cornerstones to our success. My special thanks goes to our parents who have all this time made us the number one choice of educating their children. It's with your support that we stand firm. HISU is undoubtedly grateful for your positive contribution to its growth and seeks for your continued support to make it soar. We are all grateful to our teachers who work tirelessly in nurturing the children. Through the Cambridge Assessment in the International Curriculum, you have been able to model the learners' imagination into reality via lectures, using projectors, clubs, exposure to Olympiads and expos like STEM and GISUTECH. Through activities like World Scholars Cup, we nurture the develop critical thinkers with unmatched command of the English language and opinions. We believe in developing the physical abilities of our students through games like football, table tennis, basketball, volleyball, as well as the intellectual capabilities through various mind games like chess, Scrabble, among others. Our mechanics and robotics club stimulates and enhance our students' scientific and mechanical innovation in structures. We have a top-notch boarding facility that provides our learners opportunity to focus entirely on academic through extended support in building their academic performance. Through our mentorship program, our boarding students are nurtured in disciplined and in a disciplined environment by a supportive team of mentors. Most importantly, HISU opens its doors to students from the UNEP national curriculum, whose parents and educators desire to make their children have a competitive edge in times where change creates desire for new knowledge. At Horizon, we prepare our learners to be fully for today with tomorrow's solutions, looking at a global perspective in science, technology, humanities, and creative arts. In essence, HISU suits every student according to the global standards, irrespective of their backgrounds or nationality, and successfully prepares learners to grab opportunities, including scholarships, in the leading universities in the world. HISU proudly boasts of its alumni evidenced in universities in Canada, Australia, Malaysia, and Dubai, pursuing different courses and selling the HISU image in the different universities they are situated. To the graduates, use the knowledge you have obtained to keep learning. Success comes with disciplined learning. Cambridge Education opens for you opportunities to discover the potential in having a global mindset that challenges you to think big and make use of that horizon has equipped you with to face the future with solutions. Make this investment into your future count. Thank you very much and wish you all the best in your new academic endeavors. With all of our efforts in the same vision, we can reach beyond your horizons. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, the principal.
You're welcome. Allow me to honor this occasion by calling Honorable Loic Katali to deliver her message. Thank you.
I'm here representing the Speaker of Parliament, but before I read her speech, I want to say a word or two. The Deputy Katikiro of Busoga, the Principal Management of this school, the RPC, DPC, our leaders in this place, our parents, our graduates, ladies and gentlemen, I salute you all. My name is Loi Katali, the woman MP Jinja District, and I'm humbled to be here representing the Speaker of Parliament. It is my first time to come to Horizon College. I've been to the hospital, which is your neighbor, and I've been here. And I must say that you guys are good. Katikiro, I think this is the time for you as a kingdom and to come together as Busoga and promote us, our children. The world is now a global village. If the world is a global village, we have to go international. And if you are to go international, Horizon is the place to be. So I think we should encourage people, Ugandans at large, to come and study from here. Let me read the speaker's speech. It's a graduation ceremony of Horizon College Jinja, the speech by the Right Honourable Speaker of Parliament, held on the 14th of June, 2019. I'll bring her apologies. She wanted to be here, but because of the government commitment, she couldn't. She's here in spirit, though not physically. I represent her. The principal, management, and staff of Horizon College Jinja, dear distinguished guests, parents, and guardians, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to preside over the second graduation ceremony of Horizon College Jinja. I thank the principal and management of this great institute for inviting me to officiate this ceremony. I'm happy to note that every year this college produces a big number of creative, self-reliant, respectful, and more individuals who will build a better world for us all. Under the modern economic conditions, society must see to it that there are enough jobs to go around for all of us who need them. And this is more imperative in the contemporary times when increasing more and more people are graduating with high university degrees, and yet there are hardly any jobs for them. Your contemporary approach to academic and holistic education, supported by modern technology, as per your college's mission, is therefore pertinent, especially in aiming at employability. Open-mindedness, being knowledgeable, inquisitiveness, and morally upright, as enumerated in your college's goal, are key ideals to producing both employable and self-employing individuals. Secondly, it says that no country can be better than the quality of its people. Your core values, like openness to experimentation and change, play a key role in contributing to sustainable economic growth and human development of our country through enhancement in production, manufacturing, and export. And indeed, the experience from industrialized countries indicates that economic growth is strongly linked to human resource development. Therefore, in this now globalized world, where there is easier movement of capitals, both financial and fixed assets, and technological progress, we need to increasingly turn our children into qualified manpower with a crucial comparative edge. And this is what you are exactly doing. Thank you very much. Thirdly, high quality education and training are major instruments promoting the overall socioeconomic conditions and to prevent and combat social exclusion and discrimination, particularly in employment. In order to be effective, they must cover everyone, including disadvantaged groups like women and persons with special needs. And it's therefore laudable that your college promotes culture diversity. It's heartwarming to witness your college progressing and holding its second graduation ceremony. Congratulations. I wish to congratulate the graduates who are being passed out today for this great academic success. This is a major milestone in your lives. Make this academic award a foundation for remaining relevant to the society in whatever you do. Do not wait for advertisements for jobs, nor should you exclusively pursue further education. Go into business. This is because the generation of wealth from and the significance of employment in small business enterprises is vital, even in the more advanced economically developed countries. Therefore, the engagement in small businesses enterprise is a major responsibility for all of us. I wish to pay special tribute to the members of staff of this college who have groomed, mentored, and trained the graduates. Thank you very much for your commitment. I congratulate and thank the parents and graduates for the sacrifice they have made over the years to educate their children. As I wind up, I wish to restate that the need for integral and holistic education cannot be overemphasized. There is therefore an urgent need for the financial and technical support from the government and international agencies to education and technical institutions like yours to be able to contribute more significantly to economic and social development of our country. As Parliament, we commit to increasing investment in education, the encouragement of ownership of private schools like your college, and continuing to make favorable policies and laws to enable you continue focusing on preparing children for the changing conditions of today's and tomorrow's world. Thank you very much for God and my country. May God bless you all.
Is ready, the nurse are ready. We are counting from 5 to 1. And then I shall cut the cake. Counting 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Congratulations, the audience. Thank you so much. Congratulations.